I'm ready for this album to drop, Chris. Channel FabulousBre here, and I am back with another video. And this time, I am doing a hair tutorial. I don't know, I was kind of feeling a little funky, you know what I'm saying? So, I kind of wanted to do like a high ponytail, side ponytail type of thing, because I've been seeing a lot of these pictures on Pinterest with the high ponytail type of look or whatever, and like some hair or some weave to kind of give it more of an elongated look, you know? So, yes, you guys, this is working off of my old wash and go from the Cantu product. So, if you haven't seen that video right here, I advise you to go look at it because those products are pretty bomb. And my wash and go lasts probably about a good week, you know? So, it's time to like kind of switch it up. So, but yes, you guys, if you already like how this looking, definitely give this video a thumbs up. And also, if you are new to my channel, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, because I mean, you already watching, so you might as well. But yes, you guys, so without further ado, let's just go ahead and get right into this video.
Alright, you guys, so here I'm just kind of, you know, looking at my hair, playing around with it, and then it just kind of dawned on me that I actually need to brush this out before actually going into the high ponytail. So as you see, I have a spritz bottle and it's filled with water. So what I'm doing is just spraying my hair with water all around, getting it damp enough so I can at least pull it apart to section off my hair before actually combing it out. Yes, I know that's a lot, but as you can see, like, my hair, I haven't touched it in a week. Like I stated in the beginning of this video, this wash and go lasted for about a good week. So as you see, I am like trying to section it off just to get it prepared to start brushing it out. So yeah, that was a lot. But now we're finally here to the first section, and as you saw, I sprayed it down again with some more water because it does tend to be a little dry. Like, my hair dries really fast, I don't understand. But as you see, I am taking a paddle brush and I'm just brushing it good enough to get all of the kinks out so it's easy for me to brush it up into a high ponytail without the bumps and the lumps of my curls, you know? So once I get done sectioning off a piece of my hair and brushing it out, I twist it into a two-strand twist, and just to kind of, you know, keep it out the way before moving to the next sections. But I'm gonna do that off camera and then come back looking like Felicia. So as you see, I have finally brushed my hair out and just did two strand twists, and that actually looked kind of good, you know. And I was thinking to myself, like, what if I would have kept this in overnight? This probably would have been a bum twist out, but that's something I will have to do in another video. But here I'm just going to go ahead and take down my twist and start the process of brushing my hair up into a high ponytail. And here I'm yet again going in with that water. I just want to make sure my hair is nice and damp, and I'm just trying to make sure I'm able to just really smooth it out, you know. So water for me is like my best friend and also key to a lot of hairstyles that I do as far as like slicking my hair down. I really like to make sure my hair is wet enough so when I go in with a hard bristle brush, my hair just smooths right down and I don't have any of my curls or any lumps and bumps, and it just looks so good and just you know. So as you see, I am taking a hard bristle brush. This brush I got years ago from Ulta. It's a, I think it's a Revlon brush. This brush is so perfect, but it's time for me to buy another one because I cracked it. Yes, I don't know how I did that. I think it fell on the floor and it cracked. So now whenever I brush my hair with that brush, I always end up having pieces of the bristles in my hair. And yeah, it's a sad thing, but I gotta find another brush. And as you see, my boyfriend is bothering me. He does that all the time whenever I'm doing my makeup or my hair. He always has to like ask me a question or tell me to get up to come here, and I tell him no because I'm actually in the middle of recording. So as you see, I am taking two, I like to take two bands, rubber, not rubber bands, but like hair ties, and you know, just use that to pull my hair up into a bun, but I noticed that I didn't really sleek my hair down as good as I wanted to. But it's all good because, you know, when I add this hair and wrap the hair around, hopefully it kind of like camouflages that little lump back there. But now I am going into braiding my ponytail. This is going to secure as a base for when you start wrapping the hair weft around. So you want to make sure you get it nice and firm. It can be as big or as little as you want. I wanted mine to be kind of fat because I wanted my ponytail to look as full as possible. But now, and also you saw I used a little rubber band to hold that end up, because when we go in with that first piece of the hair, I am doing the bobby pin method where you take the bobby pin and pin the section that you want in place before actually wrapping the hair around. So as you saw, I did that, and now I'm just really just wrapping, and I don't really put a lot of pins in my ponytail because for one, it's uncomfortable, and for two, it's unnecessary. So here I'm just kind of eyeball it. Like, I just wrap it around and around and around until I feel like it needs another one. I can pretty much say that I probably had about maybe 5 hairpins in this ponytail. Like, literally, I didn't have to use a lot. I probably could have used less than that, to be honest, because all you're doing is just wrapping it around and around and around, and then just kind of placing pins along the way in sections that you feel may need the security, you know, so it could just stay in place. But as you see, I'm just doing the same thing all the way up till I get to the very top of my ponytail. And then I'm actually going to take what's left of that hair, and I'm just going to keep wrapping it around. I'm not going to pin it in place because I'm just using that hair from the weft, and I'm creating kind of like a camouflaged, how can I say it? Camouflaging the top weft, basically. So I don't know if I explained it right. I feel like I'm so horrible at explaining things, but some of y'all get where I'm coming from. So that's all that matters. But as you can see, I am down to that last piece. And now I am going to take a paddle brush, and I'm just going to fluff it out because I didn't want it to be too defined with the curls from that hair. I just want it to be nice and fluffy because I love for my curly hair, like the weave that I get, to be fluffy. I don't like for it to be too defined. So yeah, and I had that tied around my head because I didn't want to mess up my hair that's already laid down from wrapping the hair around my ponytail, because whenever I do something like that, my hair always tends to mess up. So I just had that wrapped around just to keep it in place. But as you can see, I had went ahead and went in with my baby hair, and I was using the Eco Styler gel to lay down my edges. And yes, you guys, that is pretty much it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. You guys, this is like a fun go-to hairstyle for the summertime. I feel I will definitely be doing this hairstyle again, so you will be seeing this look a couple of times this summer, or, you know, for the rest of the year. But if you like this video, definitely give it a thumbs up, and like I always say, you guys, I will talk to you all in my next video. Bye.